Hello, everyone. I'm Tanya Fitzpatrick, one half of the award-winning World Footprints podcast. The other half, my husband Ian, is close behind me. We've been sharing stories with people from around the world to really put a face on the coronavirus and how it's impacting communities around the world. And today we're visiting with a very dear friend of mine, my other sister, Catherine Chambre, who comes from Chambery in the southeast region of France, near the, really in the French Alps. And Kath, I'm so happy to see you. I'm so happy that you're doing well. Thank you so much for taking time to join us today.
Thank you for having me.
So
I want to be able to talk with you and see you.
Me too. I miss you.
I do too.
So I want to ask you, I spoke to a correspondent in Britain earlier today, and he informed me that last night France experienced perhaps a record high of deaths in the country due to this coronavirus. Is that correct?
That's true, yeah. The two previous days had been more positive with a lower figure of casualties, but yesterday was bad, unfortunately. So
do they see
the trend, or if they had been talking about a plateau, but now I don't know what to think about it. Is it still going up, or are we managing to flatten the curve? I don't know what's really happening.
Now you're in more of a, you're not in a rural area, but you're in a smaller village where you are. So you're not, you don't have the dense population that Paris has. Mm-hmm. How is Chambery impacted?
Well, all the shops are closed except for supermarkets. People work from home and stay home. We are not allowed to go out except for to go shopping, for health reasons. We have to carry an ID at all times, and we have to fill in a form every time we go out. And if you want to exercise, you have to stay within 1 kilometer from your home, and you have to be on your own. If you go shopping, you have to be on your own as well. They ask you to disinfect your hands before entering the supermarket, for instance. And first, they decided to shut all farmers' markets, but recently they've decided to reopen them, but with very drastic safety measures. There are very few stalls, and they are very far apart from each other, and you have to follow circuit. You can't, you know, you have an entrance and a way out, and they disinfect your hands when you go inside the farmer's market. So it feels safe in a way, even though the atmosphere is rather heavy sometimes, because people wear gloves and masks, and you're constantly reminded that some people are in hospital or are struggling, and the streets are deserted. There are not a lot of people around. So it's a strange feeling when you do go out to run some errands, or because you have to. And it's really weird, because it's spring nowadays and we have glorious weather. And there's a discrepancy between spring and the flowers blooming and the birds singing and the sadness and the difficulty that we're in at the moment. Financially, everybody's struggling. Lots of people have lost their jobs, and Well, it's not easy. It's not an easy time.
Now, I know you're an English school teacher. The junior high level is what you teach, but you're not teaching right now for other reasons. Mm-hmm. But have they closed the school systems for the rest of the year?
They have closed the school systems. We don't know yet how long they will remain closed. So far, it's until next week, I think, mid-April or the end of April. The end of April, I think. In France, the school year traditionally ends in July, early July, first week of July. So senior students have exams, so we don't know really how things will take place, what will happen. But they've tried what they say in French, continuité pédagogique, which means not to cut off schools. Students can have lessons, online lessons. Teachers try to remain in contact with their students via the internet. Sometimes they send texts, they call. It's difficult for families to help their kids get ahead and learn new things. And it's hard work, especially if you have several kids. And sometimes they don't have the computers or the programs, the software. It's not easy, but all the same, I think some people discover a new way of learning. They try to enforce new things. So it also helps us to keep an open mind and maybe challenge ourselves and try new things, explore new ways of teaching and helping each other as well. And maybe some parents understand now that teaching is challenging and hard work. So,
yeah, and I'm sure they do.
A positive point, maybe.
So how have you adapted? What are some of the creative things you have adopted in order to adjust to this new normal?
I'm also a fitness instructor. I got my certification very recently, and I had just started teaching when the confinement was applied, and I had to stop all lessons, of course. So one of the new ways I've tried recently is to organize online sessions, workout sessions with the ladies I usually teach. So interesting, the relationships that we can create with each other, being in the same situation, having to stay home, and it creates stronger bonds in a way. Even if we don't meet in real life, the fact that we can see each other and experience something together, share a moment together, and it makes us feel good. So it's nice. It's and then of course my boyfriend has two young kids, so I try to help him teach the kids, I help them with their homework and what they have to do. And it's also a different way of being together, because sometimes I used to, I've done it before, but not as much as I do now.
So have you noticed or witnessed acts of kindness? Because we're finding that people are really extending themselves or being much more kinder to other people, to strangers. They're thanking people, police officers, medical professionals. What acts of kindness have you seen others give, or have you offered as well?
Well, people help each other, people talk to each other more, they phone each other more, they keep in touch regularly. It's true that in the streets, when you meet someone from afar, you exchange a glance or a smile or something, and there's we feel close because we experience the same thing. It makes us closer. And sometimes we share a joke, or it's true that people are less stressed out in a way, even though they could be, because maybe they could feel scared, or maybe somebody in their family is sick, or they're worried, or they've lost their job, or something like that. Mm-hmm. But generally speaking, what I experience is, a feeling of friendliness and kindness. Yes, people have more time as well. And so they take the time to exchange a few words, even at the supermarket or in the street. Sometimes someone will walk their dog and they see you from afar and just, you know, hello. Mm. And we exchange a word about the weather. And people, for old people as well. They go shopping for old people. They bring food. They bring newspapers or things they need. And every day at 8 p.m. in France, people go out on their balconies and they clap to show their appreciation for the devotion and the hard work that all the medical professions are putting in at the moment, what they do, what they have to endure and face. Because it must be scary to work in an environment when you know that maybe you risk being contaminated and all the difficulties you see and the lack of proper drugs, the lack of equipment, and yeah.
Well, Kath, thank you so much for joining me this afternoon. It's so lovely to see you. And I'm glad that you're doing well, that the family is doing well, the kids are doing well. And more than anything, it's just really nice to know that you are doing well. So be safe, stay healthy, and I look forward to seeing you soon.
Thank you, Tonya. It was really lovely to have this talk with you. Thank you so much.